Hello friends, my name is Kishan and welcome you in this video tutorial. In this video tutorial, we are going to learn about the bank ATM withdrawal process using multi-threaded example. So first of all, I would like to talk about the something is called risk condition when you design a multi-threaded application, right? So during the design of multi-threaded applications development, you should consider the possibility of race condition, which happens when multiple threads need to modify the same program resource at the same time or concurrently. The classic example is when a husband and wife are trying to withdraw cash from different ATMs at the same time, right? In this example, we have a class is called account, right? That represents a bank account. To keep the code short, this account starts with the balance of $6,000, right? And can be used only for withdrawals, right? In real scenario, this balance you will have to retrieve from the somewhere from the most probably from the RDMS database. So to keep this demo shorter, just I have hard coded with 6,000, right? The withdrawal will be accepted even if there is not enough money in the account. The account simply reduces the balance by the amount which you want to withdraw, right? Why I'm telling you like that? Because currently I haven't thought about the some kind of data protection or multi-threaded application there. We may happen some kind of race condition, will produce some kind of race condition, and after that we'll try to fix it, right? So we haven't thought about the some kind of synchronization and all, right? So let me explain you this project, each piece of this code. So first of all, we have an account, a class, it's a model class which will have a one instance variable that hard coded with 6,000 and corresponding getter method, and we have a method is called withdraw, which takes amount, how much amount basically account holder wants to withdraw, and this amount is deducted from the balance, right? It's pretty straightforward. Sorry. Now we have another class is called account holder, right? And we have a client program. So let's first go to the account holder. Account holder is basically a thread which we have implemented using runnable interface. So you can say runnable class, and here I have declared a account which is as an instance variable, and this instance variable we are initializing inside the constructor. So, and this account we are using in the run method, right, to check the current balance. If current balance is less than zero, then just we are logging some message as we happen in the real scenario, right? Somebody wants to withdraw the money, and if you find current balance is less than zero, then you would like to message something in the log file or somewhere else, right? So that's all about this logging message. Now here, from here we are calling this withdraw method four times, right? Starting from 1 to 4. So continuously we are somebody is trying to withdraw money four times, and every withdraw that guy is trying to withdraw $2,000. And let's look have a look into the make withdrawal method. It's a private method because we are accessing from this run method, and this takes an argument withdrawal amount, and here we are checking account dot get balance greater than equal to withdraw, then we are allowing to withdraw the money, right? And here we are printing the thread name. That thread name is nothing but the person name who is basically trying to withdraw the money. And I have appended some string message saying that suppose from client program you can see I have created one account, and this account I have passed to the constructor of this account holder, and here I have created two threads, thread T1 and T2. I have assigned the same runnable object, and this runnable object holds this object, mutable object, right, which we are going to share these two threads, thread T1 and T2. Thread T1 I have given the name as Jack, and thread T2 Joya. Jack and Joya, that is a husband and wife, and they are trying to basically withdraw the money at the same time from two different ATMs, and both thread I have started from here, right? Now come back here. Now here basically, and both is trying to withdraw the money, right? So this loop will iterate 4 times, and from here we are calling the withdraw method. Here we are basically, first of all, we are checking current balance is greater than equal to withdrawal amount. Then here just we are printing, suppose Jack gets the chance first, then this will print Jack is going to withdraw dollar and whatever is the withdraw amount. And after this we are making pause of 3 seconds, and here we are calling this withdraw method, which is in our account model class, right? This will deduct the amount from the current balance, right? So this method we are calling from here. So we are doing some kind of manipulation in this mutable object, right? And after that we are printing Jack. Suppose current thread is Jack, then Jack completes the withdrawal of dollar, this withdrawal amount, right? And suppose any thread comes over here and this condition gets false, then we are just printing not enough in account for suppose whatever thread is coming, that thread name to withdraw, and we are printing the account balance, right? So let's see how this example works. So from here client program we are not running, so let's see how it works. Now if you look into the output, definitely while looking into the output you can judge there is some race condition. So this data is getting corrupted by these two threads, right? When you start these two threads, right, these two threads basically enter into this method at a time, and that basically corrupted this account object, and that's what we are getting the unexpected result. So here you can see amount has been withdrawn 4 times, right? 4 times we can see the 2000, so 8000 has been withdrawn, and that was not supposed to be possible, right? Because current balance is 6000, so 3 to 6, that was supposed to be done only 3 times, right? But that was withdrawn 4 times, so 8000 has been. Apart from that, again you can see amount is showing in the, that is overdrawn, right? That is showing in the negative. And reason is that we haven't protected our data, right? So this mutable object is not protected anymore. So if you spawn more than one thread, all threads goes inside this method. So to protect this method, in Java we have a synchronized keyword, so we'll have to use synchronized keyword before this method, right? So now my method is synchronized. So if one thread is within this method, then another thread has to wait. So in Java we have a concept is called intrinsic lock. So if any thread wants to execute this method body, then thread has to acquire the lock on this account object, right? And every object is having the single lock in Java, and this lock object comes into the picture when you have a synchronized method, right? If you do not have synchronized method, then there is no meaning for the lock object lock. Once you apply lock on any method, then synchronize, once you make a method synchronized, then locks comes into the picture. So this is our basically synchronized method. Now if I'm starting two threads, if thread first gets the chance first to execute this method, then once that means thread one got the log object log to execute this method body, and one until unless thread first does not complete execution of this method, rest of the threads has to wait. So once thread one completes execution of this method, then log will be released, and some waiting thread can acquire the log, and that they can continue. There is possibility same thread will continue with the method execution as well, right? So let's after putting the synchronized keyword, let's run this application again and see now what's the output. Guys, whatever output I have shown you before the method synchronization, whatever you see over here, there is possibility in every run of your application you might get the different output. If your method buddies, if your method is not synchronized, you'll get the different output. So that output is completely unpredictable. Now if I run this application, then let's see how output we get. So here you can see Jack is going to withdraw money 2000. Now Jack's completed, right, the withdrawal. Again Jack is going to withdraw money 2000 and Jack's completed. Now Joya is going to withdraw 2000 and now Joya has completed. So see the output, how output is going to, if Jack is going to withdraw means Jack has to complete first, then again Jack is trying to withdraw money twice. So Jack again completed. After that Joya is trying to withdraw the money and that's 2000. So here now if you can see $2000 is withdrawn three times, means and balance was only 6000. After that you can see again Joya and Jack is trying to withdraw, but saying that now withdrawal is not possible because current balance is zero, right? And in that way we can basically protect our data, basically our mutable object within our method, right? Synchronized method, right? So that's all. This is a real time example, and whenever you go for the interview, then most probably you'll encounter this kind of questions. So here magic of the synchronized keyword, right? So if you do some kind of manipulation in your mutable object, so make sure that you have method is synchronized, right? And inside the method you are just doing some manipulations on the account object, and this account object is shared between the two threads. There is possibility you might have more than two thread as well, but if you have a synchronized method, then you don't need to fear. But you must know about the synchronization drawback as well. If you put the synchronization, then one thread is going to execute this method body, right? So here really we need a synchronization, so if this method to be synchronized, because this method is going to access by the more than one thread at a time. But if you don't require suppose this method is going to access by the single thread at a time, then you don't need to basically synchronize this method, else performance of your application will be degraded. So you need to understand the synchronization drawback as well. So that's all I wanted to discuss in this video tutorial. This code I'm going to check in on the GitHub, and GitHub location you may get from the video description part itself. If you really like this video, then please hit on the like button and please share and subscribe my YouTube channel as well. So guys, big thank you for watching this video, and see you next video tutorial.